Alright, so walk to the right. Over here. Jump up here. Kill Lakudu. Go into the store. And there will be clouds. And, ooh, one of these. Okay, we didn't see this last episode. Neat. I'll quickly grab these coins. Because I need more. And there it is. That's what we need, apparently. This red fruit is the thing I missed last episode that would have made Peach gigantic and will make the cloud gigantic. Hey guys and gals, I'm Pal, and welcome back to Super Paper Mario. Last time, I grew extremely frustrated with this game, more so than I have yet, though I did a very good job of not showing it, because I just don't like the level design. This time, I'm going to do my best to not rag on the game, even though I've had nothing but praise for it in the past. I have found my first issues with it, and that is the level design of this area. So let's just pass that up and talk to this guy, give him the red apple, because apparently this is the one that makes him huge. I shoot, will I score? Will eating this make me big? Cool, then I want to try it. Chomp, snark. Will it do it? Will it make him big? It makes him big! I shoot and I score with an assist from IGN. I did it, now I'm a big cloud. From now on, just call me Super Cyrus. No more little bitty cloud for me, and I'm real bouncy, so hop on top. Oh, okay. I'll hop on top. Whoa! How high did I go? Wait, what? This totally reminds me of a Mario Party. Mushroom Kadabra! Man, he was not kidding about being bouncy. We land. After blazing up in the atmosphere, we land here. What is here, though? This is number 80? Okay. We're still in the same chapter. That has not changed. And this is actually, this and the episode before last were the first parts in the game where I was not ending a chapter every episode except for Flipside areas. So, this is kind of new. It means the levels are getting a little bit longer. Here endeth the over there stair. The over there is over there. Where? Where is over there? All the way all the way over there? Okay, well, once again, this is another case of I had no clue how much longer this area would be going, so I guess we're just gonna finish the chapter right now. A little bit awkward, but something I can't really control, and it just goes to show how blind this game truly is. Sure, I'll save. Saving, please do not turn off power. Power complete, or save complete. And now, white clouds as far as the eye could see! Mario and Co. had climbed through clouds and finally reached the over there! Odd. No party springeth forth to welcometh us, wondered Luvbi be aloud. It mattereth not. Father's shrine is just up ahead, so we can walk there with ease. But they would not arrive at the shrine as easily as Luvbi be predicted. Why not? Because something unexpected and dramatic was about to happen. Wait, how can it be unexpected if you just told us that something's going to happen? Game, you're paradoxing it up here. Don't be an oxymoron. Soon we shall meet with my father, Granby. Be thou on thy best behavior. So, Granby is your father? Thou art correct. Granby is my father and Jadies is my mother. Pray listen, I fell ill once, and my father never left my bedside. They hath an overprotective side, verily, and I grow annoyed of it at times. But mayhaps it is my own fault for being so cute, they cannot help it. Yes, surely. In any case, perhaps we better go meet that Granby. And we'll do that, and this time Luvbi shall accompany us. Odd that she's not running off ahead, but I guess something happened, and she doesn't want to run off ahead. Okay, so more platforming, but it's not the oh, now it's the vertical kind. I spoke too soon. Luigi, can you help me with this? Thank you, buddy. The guy's desperate to throw his head at us. And that guy's desperate to hit us with his head. Peach, can you make that? You can. What is the use of that platform? Okay, there's a locked door. Over there, Sector 1. There's also a item box that I want to investigate. Odd. Okay. I feel like there should be a reward for doing this. And there is one of these. Okay. Peach, I need you. Nice. Nice. Oh, this is good. This is good. I fell. Do I still have this going? I do. I fell again. This thing's so incredibly hard to control. It's so hard to control. You know what? I'm gonna do it again. Got it. Okay, that's all I wanted. That's all I wanted. This power-up is very, very unyieldy. And I got a mushroom for my troubles. Okay, that's cool. This is locked. It's locked. No dialogue connected to it. So I guess we're just going to jump back down. Go through this door instead. What's in this door? Oh, hey, it's a person that needs help. Ha! What is the matter? Come on, fight back, you big wimp, ya! What's your beef, huh? Oh, friend of the NIMBYs, are ya? Then you must be an enemy of us! Taste spear! Okay, I'll gladly defeat you for points. Nice. Just stay in the air getting a massive style. They're not even paying attention to me. And done. Excellent! Got 420 experience. Teehee, I am mature. Thou hast my gratitude. Oh my goodness. Yes, this game may make up for the terrors that was last level. Because more old English! Thou hast my gratitude. I know not who thou art, but thou didst save me. Pray speak, what hast happened hither? A pox, verily. Yon fell beast hath been flooding into the over there of late. They seek the pure heart. They need it, for they hath some plan most foul. Yon beast seek the pure heart? Foulness! Only father knoweth the pure heart's resting place. Father is in danger. I yearn to hide, verily. But if thou seeketh Granby, then thou shalt need this key. Very cool. I cannot help more, but prithee, protect Granby. Farewell. I shall, reconvene with you at a later juncture. Yeah, juncture. That's a reference. Okay, let's go on before I make even more Ruby references. Even though that's not a bad thing. And if you haven't watched Ruby, watch Ruby! Because normally I talk about Dragon Ball Z and I make Dragon Ball Z references, but this area is just crawling with Ruby references to be made. Okay, so there's another locked door. Over there, Sector 3. Let's stick with Peach from here on out for a while. From here on out for a while. Thou art specificeth. Style. Get styled, son. Cool. Last minute style. And there's a point to that. Definitely. Yes, there is. Okay. What is... That's weird. That's really weird. Those little indicators? I have no clue what that's about. Peach, I need you again. All that was for one coin, so it's not worth it. Hello? Sniff. Oh, woe is me. My darling hath been frozen by brute monsters. I need him so. I am Falby, a helpless kitten compared to them. Oh, what shall I do? Thou art a kitten too. Or art thou a grand lion? Prithee, lion, help mine man. If only we had a pixel that could breathe fire. If only. Also, that didn't melt, it broke. What's the deal with that? It didn't even melt, so fire doesn't even, okay, whatever. Ung. Darling dear, fair Falby. Sniff, thank heavens, yon person helped thee. Thou hast my thanks, yeah? Pray, allow me to do something for thee in return. Yeah, verily, darling dear, perhaps if thou wouldst move the thou knowest what. Yeah, the thou knowest what. Fair, Falby, thou art as clever as thou art adorable. Oh, darling dear, 'tis true, but how thou goest on. Let us away. Pray, wait, my lovely Falby fair. Okay. The thou knowest what? Odd, okay. Peach! Get back here. Also, this place is like my haven. Even if I do mess up the pronunciation and the enunciation of their speech, I still love old English. I read a King James Bible, and so like this stuff is my jam and my bread and butter. It's actually an entire sandwich to me. Aw, look at him work. Is he not just the cutest? Aw, man, he's working. You see that working? Sorry to make us thee wait. Behold, the overvator. It transporteth nimbies upward. I owe thee for thine help. I operate yon lift. Prithee, let me giveth thee a ride. Goest thou up? Going up! It probably throws me off because it's old English mixed with modern English, and that's just kind of weird. But it's still cool. I like the characters of this area, even if I didn't like the design of last episode. I guess I didn't like the design of last episode mainly because I was still a little bit upset over the loss of 1,080 coins in the episode previous, so I guess it's not entirely the game's fault. And yeah, hither we are. Thank thee for using the overvator. No problem. If only, you know, it would be really nice if we had a source of heat for these pixels. Brr, monsters most foul, how dare they freeze me? I shall get to them. I shall have at thee. Oh, what happened to me? For a reason I know not, I feel chilled. Okay, so it wasn't actually imperative that I do that, but it is imperative that I go through this door, because otherwise I can't progress the game, and each episode would just be me being, if only I could, I had like a Mr. Heater right now that I could start a source of waves of intense vibrating air that could possibly combust in such a way that it would cause this solid to change into its liquid form. Didst thou save me? Thank thee. I could create a chemical reaction to melt, as the commoners say, that ice. I have no clue what I'm saying. Phew, thank thee. I know not what thou art, but thank thee. And you. Thank thee for saving me. Being frozen is no pleasure. Will I ever be warm again? I don't know. You know, I would get back to you on that when I have a pixel that could breathe fire. Thank thee for saving me. I thought I had shuffled off this immortal coil. I have frostbite everywhere. Wherefore hath this happened to me? You know, it'd be really nice if these people could not be frozen. If only I could do that. Thank thee, thou save me. Pray, dost what thou canst for the others. You know what? I'm gonna stop milking the joke. Melt them! You guys remember the joke, right? I'm not just speaking nonsense to you. Ack, I drip with moisture, but doth it make mine hair look hot? Haha, you shot for the pun. You shot, honey. And you know what? You know what? Sure, you get, that's a one-pointer right there. That was so terrible. Makest those beasts pay for their wrongs. And you know what? It'd be really nice if I could break this somehow. You know what? Okay, you guys get the joke. The joke is from an earlier episode where there was there were vines covering a door. In fact, I think the episode's called I'm So Dumb or something. And I had Bowser. I was looking at the door. And I was like, if only I had a pixel that could breathe fire. That maybe I'll get that this level. And I realized I have stinking Bowser. Whoa, thank thee for thine help. My given name is Luvbi. I owe thee for that one. Thou art super. Luvbi speaketh of my father. How doth he fare? I'm sorry, Luvbi. I could not stop yon beast from entering Rambi's shrine. And the fiends wrecked the bridge once they crossed it. Help cannot reacheth him.
Man, all I hear is crying. Show a little initiative. Can't we rebuild the bridge?
Mayhap. To rebuild it, thou must find Rebby, Blubby, and Yebby, and get their three orbs. Once thou hast them all, we can rebuild the bridge. Take this and findeth the others, I beg of thee. Thou must help. Got a door key. It's very dorky. Because that joke's never been made before. Why do I have Dudley? I did it for platforming purposes, but I need Carrie. Thank you, Carrie. Okay, so that's the base of the bridge, I assume. You know what? I have a theory. Is there something on top of this? There better be. There is! What? Oh, I was like, what? That's a weird chest, but it's not a chest. It's actually a store. What's in the store? Hey, and welcome to the teeny tiny food store, 80 bits. Real good to see you. What'll it be for today? First of all, I'd like to check points. Thanks for being a bunch of points. Okay, what can I buy? That's a lot of money. Wow, I don't want either of these. So, thanks, but no thanks? I mean, I feel like the point of having a little shop is that people could buy a hot dog that costs like -0 cents to make because it requires zero materials and then grow it. But like, no, they clearly say no, it costs a lot of money. So I'm just not gonna bother with that. Was there a locked door below? I think there was. I probably could have just jumped down. But I guess this will work too because then I can actually get up. So there's a save block. And where was that locked door? I don't remember. Was it this way? Oh boy, I need Peach. I almost failed the jump. There we go. Where was that locked door? I have an inkling that it was here. But it wasn't. Okay, where was it though? Oh man, backtracking is never a good thing because you have no clue how far you're supposed to go back, and it can just be a nightmare. Oh, there it is. Never mind. Okay, it was okay. Use a key. But yeah, backtracking can be quite bad because you never know how back you're supposed to go unless you like explicitly know exactly where you're supposed to go. I mean, if they say, oh yeah, at the bottom of the elevator, and then you say, okay, that makes sense. But if they say, you have to go back, and you're like, where do I go? They say, back. You say, okay, but that doesn't explain anything. Where am I supposed to back? And you just facepalm. There's a secret door here. Let's go through this one first, because it looks cool. And it's barely shown through that gap. Read the sign. Over there, sector 7? Oh boy, are we supposed to go here? Like, is this where we're supposed to progress? Take it that! I feel like it is. Man, that guy just beat up someone. Oh no, there are more. They come without pause. Against such an assault, I cannot hope to last. His hair is literally lightning. That's amazing. Also, I use literally too much. Huh? Reinforcements? At last, my strength hath reached its end. Please, thou must finish them. Okay. Bowser? Could you breathe on them? Thank you. Could you breathe on that one too? Thank you. Hey, buddy, I heard that you had some problems. Where were those beasts? I literally, stop it, pal. Don't say it anymore. No more. The foul beasts are no more. I am Rebby. Thou hast saved me. I owe thee thanks. Luvbi must go to his right in order to speak. Rebby, Granby is in trouble. Hast thou the red orb? Luvbi, the three orbs are not things to be given away lightly. And yet, these are dire times, are they not? And I owe thee a big debt. Here, I give it to thee. We got the red orb. I go thither? Thither? I haven't heard that one before. I go thither and check on the others. If thou survivest, let us meet again. And he will fly. Why couldn't he have done that, flown away from the enemies? That seems like a really simple solution. And yet, the simplest solutions are often the ones that evade our grasp. Okay, so it was good that I went in here. It was a dead end. So let's go back. Go through the door we're supposed to go through. And see where that leads. Because We need 3 orbs, and there are 2 paths here. So unless this one splits in 2, I don't know where I'm supposed to go. Oh boy. Not this. Peach. You're gonna be pretty useful here. If only it slowed down time for everyone else. No. Jump over. I can't get in. Okay, now, I just want the points. I just want the points. Okay, of course I don't. Once again, that's a perfect example of them giving you a slow shroom in the worst possible location, purposefully setting you up to fail. And that's just annoying. At least with the fast shroom, oh boy. At least with the fast shroom, they give you a chance. They say, hey, we're going to give you a shroom that makes you really fast, but we're also going to place 5 bajillion tons of enemies in the way, so you're either going to get really hurt, but if you're good at the game, then you can avoid that. But with this, they say, here, we're going to give you 1 enemy in an almost impossible to reach location, and good luck. No answer. Looks like he's faking it. Burn him? No. No answer. It looks like he's faking it. What am I supposed to do? His injury's not serious, but it doesn't seem to get any better since he's so distracted. What are we supposed to do? Piccolo? I mean, this is an optional pixel, so it's not Piccolo. No. Slim? Let's try Slim. Doesn't work. I thought maybe when he didn't see us, he would come out of the woodwork. What on earth? What on earth? Like, what are we supposed to do? He's faking it, so what does that mean? That doesn't mean anything. It just says, oh, he's laying in the ground. You have to do a specific thing. Game, don't do the game design thing on me again. Thuddly? Will that wake him up with ground pounds? No. No answer. Looks like he's faking it. And what was it that she said about him? That's maybe this NIMBY has been injured. His injury's not serious, but it doesn't get any better since he's so distracted. By what? Game. Don't. The frustration's coming back. It's coming back, guys. It is coming back. What am I supposed to do? I've tried everything, unless I haven't. It would be a required item. I tried everyone but Luigi. Luigi. He's faking it. Ugh, that's so infuriating. That's, you know what? No, I'm just going to leave. Even though it's, I have to be here. I have to. What am I supposed to do? Game. You're so vague. More enemies. And I got Merlee. Okay. Start the wheel of fun. I'm content with that. That's cool. But don't fall down. Don't troll me like that, game. That was a brilliant jump. Jump over here. And there's a little bit of game slowdown, actually. Whoa, a lot of enemies. Have we been here before? I don't actually know. I don't remember. Cool. I don't want pal pills. This is the last thing I want is for the game to troll me even more. Luigi? No, not Mario. I said Luigi. Jump up. There's an enemy there. And a heal shroom. Ow. Really? Pal, don't get frustrated. Don't blame the game. Just realize your own faults and then realize the game faults. The game faults are sending you back. I don't know why I'm getting so frustrated with this. Like, it's pretty much just the game being the game at this point. I'm noticing it now. Well, I got my second orb. Oh, thank thee. It is as though thou hast brought me back to life. Hold a moment. What am I doing hither? Who am I? Where am I? Do I have amnesia? Oh, what to do? Where am I? When is it? Hold a moment. I remember. I am Luvbi. she must once again go to the right of you to be able to speak. Finally, thou snappeth out of it, Dumby. Wow, that's really mean. We hasten to yonder shrine to help Gramby, so give us thy blue orb. What? Oh, indeed, I see. Fell beasts have attacked from the underwear, and Gramby is in danger? If thou speakest truth, then here, takest it. And we got our second of three orbs. I cannot linger hither. I must go see what is happening. Farewell, Luvbi. All right, so we're two-thirds of the way there. Get back in here, Carrie. Carrie, there you are. All right, where am I supposed to go? Kill that guy instantly. Something down here. There was. And I'll take a bunch of damage. That's fine. I have the HP to sustain that now. Jump over here. No, 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 you're not going to do that. You're going to die. There we go. And go back through the door. Now, I'm not sure exactly where we're supposed to go from there, because I feel like we've kind of run out of tracks to go on. Unless we could go back to that guy. Yeah, let's do that. We're going to go back to that guy who was playing dead. I don't think what are they called? NIMBY was special in any way. I mean, it just looked like a generic NIMBY, but that's our only lead. So let's go back to him now that we have all these orbs. Take this incredibly slow transporter. It's not really an elevator because we're not elevating. And then go back through the first door. Actually, also, this is a good idea. Get Mario. Flip. And kill all these enemies off. Because there could be something that triggers when that happens. In fact, this is actually a pretty smart idea. That guy could be... You know what? I don't have to take this. That guy could be hiding from the enemies. So let's just use this. Shake it up and down. Get a full charge. And deal a lot of damage to all of them. Now, let's see if that changes anything. It may not, but it does not hurt to check. So we'll go back to that guy. And maybe he's not playing dead? No answer, he's faking it. Maybe it's one of those things that I have to keep talking. Let's try this a little bit. He's faking it more. I just find it incredibly odd that it leads all the way up to this and there's no reason for it. Okay, well, I guess not. We'll leave him alone. Okay, let's go back and let's progress. Let's go to the furthest point that we've been to thus far and just see. This is kind of odd because I have no clue what we're supposed to be doing at this point. But we'll try. We'll definitely try. In fact, actually, no. I'm going to backtrack further just so I don't have to do it later and I know where things are. Wait a minute. You see this? Never mind. There's something over here. What is up here? Oh, this is new. This is certainly new. What's up here? That's odd, and it actually gives that room a reason to exist. What is this? Over there, Sector 6. Okay, so never mind. We found where we're supposed to go. I am so glad that I found that. And you have no clue how glad, because if I had left that, I probably wouldn't have been back for a long time. I would have checked every part of the level I've been to thus far, and then finally given up and come back. So, oh my goodness. I am glad. Oops. Switch Peach. Is there anything over there? Huh, over there. No, there's nothing. So, it has to be up. Yeah, it has to be up there. That's our hint. So, Luigi? They're really pushing the Luigi mechanics, and I like that. Further? No. What is this room for? The plot thickens, or the side questy nonsensicalness thickens. Oh, there it is. Okay, so there's a whole other series of things going on here if we just jump over this way. Okay, so we are making progress. I'm very happy about that. Get this and get... Oh, nice. It's been a long time since we've seen this, and it is quite welcome, though I regret that I didn't get it with Luigi. You guys know what the 8-bit sprite looks like, so we can just imagine it in our face minds. Ah, this feels good. This is great stress relief. Just break all those blocks. Get all that damage in. We're actually all close to the next level already. Kill all these enemies. Nice. We're pretty close to the next level. What does this lead to, though? Another... Ah, that's what it is. Okay. So we're over here. Is that a bathroom? That is. That's a bathroom. Why is there a bathroom here? Why is there a bathroom all the way out here? Are the fell beasts gone? So is it safe for me to come out hit thither? By the way, who art thou? Mario, Granby, a monster. Heh. We're a monster. A monster? Thou liest! No monster would admit to being a monster. Huh? Hold a moment. That meaneth... Thou art not a monster? Was that the right answer? Okay. That's cool. Hello to thee. I am Yebi. Thou came to rescue me? I shall now go on to the left of you to speak. We must rebuild yon bridge to reach Granby. Thou must give us the yellow orb. If thou dost not, we shall tell all how long thou spent hiding in thither. Luvbi? Oh, prithee, thou must not tell. I shall do all that thou asketh. And we got the yellow orb. I should not have hidden like a base coward. I goeth to help the others now. Be thou careful. Very nice. That's the last orb, and so I will meet you back where we need to place the orbs. I assume it's where the bridge begins, so let's go there now. Back up at the top. We have all three orbs. So let us... Is this it? Yeah, this is it. Let us go through this door and go to build a bridge. Man, this is new. We haven't done this before. Will it be rainbow? Will it be made out of bricks? Twigs? Will it be made out of people? I don't know. Blue orb. Whoa, this is a very Zelda moment right now. It's beautiful. And the red orb. Oh. Da 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 da. It is the 8-bit bridge. It's gorgeous and made of a rainbow. It is lacking a lot of color. No, never mind. It's rainbow. It's pulsating. It is all colors and blue. It is great, and we shall save this thing for us. Cool. And we'll go across the bridge. It's made out of light from the sky somehow. Oh boy, it's so good. Also, that was very off key. I'm kind of ashamed. Okay, go through the door. What's here? Monsters? Aliens? Zombies? Someone yelling, hold it? Is it old man watch it? It's his brother. I guess, I don't know. How do you guys get in here? I thought we destroyed the bridge. Shuttest thy trap, foul one. Speakest. Doth my father farewell? If thou hast heard a whisker on his face, I shall end all that is you. What? You little brat. Hey, you guys, fall in. Hey, guys. How's it going? So, you want to see how scary we can be, little girly? Well, take a good look. Oh, dear, there seems to be a lot of them. I didn't know there were so many left. Calm thy mind. No, I want to beat them myself. I shall handle them. You. At long last, my strength has returned to me. And now, these fiends shall reap the grim harvest of my NIMBY fury. The hour's nigh, NIMBY brigade. Art thou ready? Yeah! Can the Wii handle this? There are a lot of sprites on screen. Hast thou fear of these fiends from the underwear? Nay! Ooh, all tough because you got an army, huh? Let's see how you do against mine. You're going down. Thou art toast. Oh boy, they have no weapons. And the sprites will not be able to handle this. NIMBY Brigade, charge! No mercy! Okay. There are... this isn't our fight, I guess. It's theirs. Okay, they're sacrificing themselves. I can't really make this serious. It's just too hilarious. And also, I'm impressed. Please get a style, game. I'm shaking the Wiimote like crazy. No, I'm jumping right on his head. Let me jump on his head. And I shook the Wiimote like crazy and didn't get a style, whatever. Okay, let's just continue on, I guess. Make their sacrifices not be in vain. Once again, I can't take this seriously. It's too ridiculous. Let's just continue on, leave those enemies behind. They'll clean it up, surely. What's in here? Save block, a one up, which gives us a lot of health, and a door. Let's go through the door. Episode's not over yet, because I have a feeling that if I ended it right now, it would be like 3 seconds until it end properly in the next episode. So we're gonna run this level out until it finishes. Oh no. Father, father, art thou all right? Luvbi, thou should not have come. Flee from here. A touching scene to be sure. Whoa. Whoa. Well, you must be the boss of all the creatures that escaped the underwear. A pleasure to make your acquaintance, I assure you. My name is Bonechill. I am something of an evil celebrity in certain circles of the underwear. That may be, but my father shall never give you the pure heart, so givest up. Oh, you dear ignorant child. You really don't know a thing, do you? How charming. What dost thou mean? I speak of the pure heart, and I speak of you, Luvbi. It is you. What sayest thou? The pure heart was hidden ingeniously to keep it away from evil sorts like me. Gramby changed the pure heart into a NIMBY that he called his own daughter. Haha, that is just silly. My mother and father... Oh, priceless, you really think Gramby pays an ounce of attention to you out of love? No, thou liest. Father, say us something. Luvbi. The old fool can weigh the sins of others, but not his own. It cannot be. Luvbi, we can talk later. Right now, just take Gramby to safety. Quickly. Okay. Many thanks for delivering the pure heart. Once I deal with you, none can stop me. I shall be invincible! Please, as your game ends, remember it is an honor to have it ended by my talents. Alright, this is what... What is he? I don't... That's a very slow-moving thing. Stuck it, I guess? I'm trying to... Here, quickly, let's look at this. What is he? That's Bonechill. This fridged boss escaped from his prison in the underwear. HP is 80, attack is 4. Bonechill will only be hurt by his attacks if they're on his head. To hit his head, you need Luigi's super jump or throw to toss icicles. Bonechill's icy breath can freeze you into a solid hero-sicle. I don't know why, but I get the feeling he's related to Gramby and the NIMBYs. That's odd. I wonder if he was once a what? I'm really curious now, because that actually seems like there's a backstory. Duck! Grab one. All right, they're icicles, grab one. This actually reminds me a little bit like the fight in Luigi's Mansion where you fight the icicle dude. You remember the one where he like gets really angry that you started a fire in his area. And this reminds me of that for whatever reason, probably just because there's ice. But yeah, Bonechill is actually a pretty interesting character off first impression. Like, it's kind of cool because he's the first antagonist, I mean, besides Bowser, that is doing his own thing. Mainly, they're just servants of Count Black, but this time, he's serving himself. He's trying to become independently powerful, not destroy all worlds. And, I mean, if you think about it, he's probably pretty against Black, because if all worlds are destroyed, then all of his power now means nothing. So he's actually kind of cool. And there seems to be a backstory to him. He's also pretty steampunk if you look at him, but I'll look past that. Although steampunk is pretty cool. There's nothing wrong with steampunk. Okay, also as we damage him, more and more of his color leaves. And he's slowly just becoming this skeletal form. Oh, I'm frozen. I don't want this. All right, I'll get hit there. Throw it at him. Can I style off these? I'm not sure. I don't really care at this moment because we're not about styling right now. We're about killing this guy. Okay, frozen. Good. I'm free. Throw it at him. Oh, I missed. Or it was blocked. Get out of the ice. There's a couple second grace period, it seems, to get out of the ice before you're frozen. Okay, grab the icicle. Throw it at him. Grab this one. I miss. Okay. I missed him again. Ow. Oh, boy. Okay. I can take a hint. Let's just use a super shroom shake. I don't really feel like I need a long last. I just need a little bit of HP so I can survive the next couple hits. Okay, I got him there. And actually, I can just jump into him. Okay, that's nice. And he's dead. Brog! How impossible. How could you puny worms destroy a master of the cold dark? Wow, that's a cool enemy. And is he truly dead? He is, and he died in he died in such a creepy fashion. He turned into a skeleton and just disintegrated. Thou hast done a fine job. Thou hast saved our realm. Father, the words of that thing were lies, yeah? Thou and mother art my parents? Well, Luvbi. Luvbi. Mother. I had not received word of your safe arrival, so I came looking. Are you well? Speakest to me now, mother. Father and thee, art thou verily my parents? Wait a minute. Why do you... What? Prithee, mother, speakest the truth to me. Luvbi, you... You are not really our child. So it is true. The pure heart was always in danger of falling into the hands of evil, darling. So Grams and I decided to transform it into a shape that no one would suspect. And that was... me? What? What was that? The pure heart doth struggle against the Luvbi identity. It seeketh its true form. It doth sense someone nearby worthy of possessing it. It must be these fair folk. So, thou sayest I am meant to be with him? He verily is my prince? This doth stink. He is completely wrong for me. I speaketh seriously to you. This hath no humor to it. Fine, I shall return to my pure heart form, and I shall go with Mario and his friends. Thou art certain? If thou turneth back into the pure heart, the NIMBY known as Luvbi will cease to exist. Nay, perhaps I already have. I remember being a pure heart now, in truth. And the world would end if I did not do it. Is this not so? So I should just... Wait, why do I explain myself to thee? Thou art not my real father, so quiet! What? To think of all the times thou hast scolded me. Thou didst know I was not long for this world. Why didst thou not let me have fun? Nay, indeed, I suffered an angry fake father and a nagging fake mother. I had no life. How dost thou plan to make that up to me? Luvbi. Sayest thou what thou wilt to me, but talketh not to my mother that way, or to thy mother that way. Perhaps thy sass shall end once thou changest form. What dost thou wait for? Oh, giveth me a break. I must do it whether thou wish or not. It shall be a relief. Thou art an ungrateful brat. Dost thou not recall when I lingered by thy ill bedside? I scoff at thy lingering. Why dost thou not giveth me back the present I bought with my saved allowance? What madness doth spew from thy lips? Who gaveth thee that allowance? And thou didst lie to get the money, too. Thou didst pretend to buy school books. How dost thou dare lecture on lying? And I... Wait, I can scroll up. Yeah. And why dost thou think I lied? I thought that mother and thee... I thought thou wouldst be happy. The pair of thee. Thou art not real parents. I hate thee. That is enough, Luvbi. It is true that we created you as a means of protecting the pure heart, but Grams and I came to love you as a true daughter. We wanted to be with you for all time, to protect you. You became a part of us. Perhaps we were wrong to create you, and if we only caused pain, we apologize. Oh, mother, thou needest not apologize. Thy dear mother, thank thee. The pure heart doth wish to assume its original form. Luvbi. Tippy, takest good care of the real me, and saveth the world, yeah? Such is my final wish, so if thou dost not do it, thou art most unkind. I understand. Father, mother, fare thee well. Luvbi. Oh, my darling. I am sorry for lying earlier, because in truth, I love thee both. Wow. There was a lot of character development there. And actually, the level design aside, this might be my favorite chapter, just because of Luvbi. I said I liked her as a character, and that was mainly just because she was kind of old English, but after that, that's a really good story right there. Luvbi. Now, ye prophesied ones, destined heroes, takest our dear daughter, takest the pure heart. Thank you, Granby. And sweareth this to me, thou must prevail. Let no one else in the universe feel this sadness. Of course. Very well, then I am satisfied. Now, Luvbi, thou must go. Oh, Grams. And we got a pure heart. Wow. That was really good. And actually, if you kind of think about it, they were her real parents. I mean, what is saying a real parent other than the fact that they, you know, that her mother gave birth to her? But in a sense, they did. It's just she was born instantly into... Although maybe she wasn't. Maybe she was a child and she was created as a child. But they were real parents and she just failed to see... She saw the means to an end, not what they were actually doing. The end of her being their daughter. Heroes, my daughter wanted thee to save all worlds. 'Twas her final wish. Granby spoke slowly through his tears as the brave Nimbys cleaned up the over there. Draped in sadness, Queen Jadis walked slowly to her palace in the underwear. Mario, his friends, and the 8th Pure Heart were all that remained. This pure heart had come at a high price. Let us hope it is all worthwhile. Wow, that was a good chapter. My frustrations with the game aside, the story was good, the characters were very deep, there was a lot of humor, and there was me surviving at 1 HP. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode in any capacity, please click like. And if you didn't, then drop a comment telling me I could make the next episode so that you would like it. Next time in Super Paper Mario, we're going to be starting the search for the 8th Pure Heart. And I will see you guys then. Although, actually, we may not do that. We may, I don't know, we may do the Pit of 100 Trials. I may be ready. If I am, post in the comments. Otherwise, I will look up the best time to go to the trials. And maybe I'll do that next episode. I don't know. But like I said, I will see you guys next time. I release new episodes of Super Paper Mario Tuesdays and Thursdays. Saturdays are periodically ABOs, and I'll see you guys next time.